Another update for you now. An NFL player from Southwest Florida is fighting back this morning. Nate Allen is criticizing how the Fort Myers Police Department handled an accusation against him, something the state attorney's office now calls a false accusation. Allen and his attorney just wrapped up a news conference. NBC2's Lucas Seiler was there and joins us live to tell us what they said. Lucas, good morning.
Heather, good morning. Nate Allen's attorney, Sawyer Smith, started off the press conference by saying both Nate Allen and his family have been attacked by the very people who were supposed to protect them. Now they're calling on the Fort Myers Police Department to make major changes so this never happens to anyone again. Now, on February 16th, the Fort Myers Police Department received a 911 call from a 16-year-old girl claiming a man exposed himself to her. She provided a description of him, also the vehicle he was driving. That same night, Nate Allen was pulled over by Fort Myers police and he ended up being detained for hours. Now, that 911 call came in at around 4:54 p.m. the 16th, and the state attorney's office just yesterday told us that there is no way that Nate Allen could be responsible for this crime because they have proof. They say they have surveillance video of him eating at a restaurant around that same time and also taking pictures with fans, which were then posted onto social media. And Nate Allen took a turn speaking at the mic after his attorney did. He said that his heart goes out to that 16-year-old girl, saying that she is the true victim in all this. And then he spoke of how this incident has frankly damaged his reputation.
I would never do something like this, and that evidence has shown that it was literally impossible for me to do this, and that, you know, my whole character and you know, entire existence isn't thrown up into question all off a false accusation.
And then Nate Allen went on to say that since the beginning, the NFL and the Philly Eagles have been supportive of him since day one, and they didn't believe that he was responsible for this. So the next step here, the attorney tells us, is reaching out to the police department here, asking them to release all evidence they have on this case. They say they're still waiting for them to do that, and once they do, they'll review it, and they haven't told us whether they plan on filing a suit against the agency. Now, we've reached out to the state attorney's office and the Fort Myers Police Department following this press conference, and we've been told no comment just yet. Reporting live in downtown Fort Myers, Lucas Seiler, NBC2.